my organization, you know, I call it shared leadership. But you know, I've been with LeaderSpring for a year, and I've followed a founder, you know, who had more of a top-down approach, and so trying to change that culture and give people room to make decisions or to actually see the budget and to be a part of discussions about, you know, their titles and their salaries and what they need, you know, is really hard. So how do you do that in terms of decision making if, you know, you have a hierarchical, larger structure that you're working within?
When I first came into the organization, it was extremely hierarchical, had a different artistic director at the helm. When we went through this huge change around our culture, we started to try to make some of that change. And the problem that we ran into a lot is that there was people at every level of the organization used to the old way of doing things. So you have the staff who maybe don't have as much decision-making power and are not willing to take risks or kind of get out of whatever their zone is, even to share with you what isn't working. Right. So you can't even get that information to begin with. And then the next layer up, even if you get the staff to be able to do that or bring new people in, when they come in, they're like, oh, everyone else is working under this other structure. So it's almost like you can't address it from any one level. You have to do it all at once, and it's a long time.
What about for you, Alan? Because I know you started that way, and for musicians, there's a natural collaborative process that happens.
That's right. from what I know, in the very beginning of Orpheus' history, there was a complete absence of structure and hierarchy at all. This has been, I think, one of the major hurdles for the organization is to grow and find ways to go beyond the original foundations, the origins of the group. And the decisions, all the artistic decisions get made by an artistic planning group. And this is really shared leadership because it involves different constituencies of the organization. So just about every decision at Orpheus is a group decision. Committees are involved in just about every decision. And of course, that all originates from the music making process, which was always what I mentioned before. Yeah, the musicians getting together, taking a piece of music, starting with a small group from within that larger framework. Everybody has a voice, and yet it does become necessary to have some kind of structure. We learned that over the years, and as Orpheus has grown older, it's become increasingly necessary to make sure that structure is in place and really be clear about what each position within the structure and the organization is responsible for.
Yeah. I mean, just kind of building off of what you're saying, Ellen, I think there are our organization for Terrain, every major kind of decision that's going to affect the organization as a whole, we get together. We're, you know, a smaller group, but we get together and we kind of just hash it out and all opinions on the table, and we build consensus, and that's how we move forward. Again, you can work collaboratively and still have kind of leads and roles within an organization. At least that's how we're kind of running things. I also think it's important to point out that we're human too, and kind of going back to your question, Sonia, Terrain is my baby. I feel like I'm a pretty capable person. So there are definitely times where I'm like, I'm the executive director, I'm the founder, I want to make this decision, you know.
You call the trump card.
Yeah, exactly. But I have to stop myself because I realize that I'm a better leader, and we're a stronger organization when there is that more of that consensus building. So I just want to point out that it's not without internal conflict. There are certain, it's not because I don't want to lead, you know, like I don't want to be the leader because I have an ego, and you know, I certainly think that I have those sorts of tendencies, but I know again that, you know, the organization is stronger. I'm a better leader because being challenged and hearing different opinions or different viewpoints, or what about this, or what about adding that, more than not, we have a better event, or we have a better program, or we have a happier group of staff members, or whatever it happens to be when we engage in kind of that collective brainstorming.
So at the end of the day, it's about culture shifts, right? It's about changing the culture of what, you know, we have grown up in the systems that we've inherited that we may or may not, you know, feel comfortable in, but it's kind of the normal. So we're pushing against that, right?
Well, I totally agree, Ginger, with what you just said. And for me, it's also about engagement of the staff and a fundamental belief that more brains are always better than fewer. Right. And so the ability for people to build on each other's ideas not only leads to a better idea in the end, but also gets everyone excited about the project. Mm-hmm. And so for me, decision making is collaborative because I think that's what yields the best decisions. But also, especially if you give it enough time and space, you're never getting to a point where you're surprising someone with a decision. Because everyone has been involved and had a say and helped refine it and helped create something that no one could have done on their own. So I think there are a lot of benefits.